all you adult readers out there who are looking for some great reading recommendations. Today I'm going to introduce you to three books that I have loved and that I think are especially appropriate for this time of the year when we're out and about exploring the places around us here on the West Coast, new places and favorite places. These three books that I'll talk about today absolutely revel in our West Coast environment and make us realize how lucky we are to live here. So the first book is a West Coast classic, The Curve of Time. It has been continuously in print since its publication in 1961. And in fact, it's so popular, when I went to borrow it from the library, there were 41 people that had requested it ahead of me. Anyway, I had to borrow a copy from a friend, and it's not hard to find a copy. Almost all of my family and friends have one. It's just a classic if you live here on the West Coast. So Muriel Blanchet published The Curve of Time just months before she died at her typewriter, typing up the prequel. The death of her husband when she first moved to BC is another sort of curious story. They moved here, and 4 years later, in his 30s, her husband disappeared on the boat. His body was never found. But regardless, Muriel takes her five young children out in the Caprice, the name of the boat, for the next 15 or so summers of their lives, and goes up and down the coast, in and out of the coves and inlets of the Salish Sea, and has many adventures with wild animals, and especially my favorite parts, stories about the characters that she meets, the people who live in the extremely remote areas of BC's rugged West Coast. She got the name of the book from a theory of time that says that time, rather than being linear, can be seen all at once, past, present, and future. And in fact, she writes the book in that way. The book does not follow a chronology. It is instead just her favorite memories and stories of their explorations of the coast. And they're just wonderful. And she has a great love of the beauty of nature on the coast, and some exciting run-ins with wild animals. But my favorite parts are the characters, the people that she gets to know, that live off the land, live a very rugged, self-sufficient life. So very similar to The Curve of Time, so many similarities. Fishing with John by Edith Iglauer. Sort of a lot of similarities with Muriel Blanchet. Both women were moved out to BC's West Coast from a very urbanized East Coast of North America. Edith Iglauer was a journalist and a writer for The New Yorker in New York City, when through a mutual friend she meets John Daly, a commercial fisherman who had been fishing for 40 plus years and had a great amount of knowledge about navigating the waters of BC's West Coast, the commercial fishing industry, the sea life, and again, my favorite parts, many of the people who lived in the remote areas. A lot of couples and single people who lived all alone sometimes, with nobody anywhere near them. And the descriptions of their gardens and how they lived off the lands, and especially of the pets that they made of wildlife and how they interacted and lived in harmony with wildlife and nature. And in fact, one of my favorite parts is when he is in a very remote area in the Quatsino Inlet, Edith and John, and they talk about a tame seal that's been made a pet by a store owner there. The water was so warm that year that we went swimming and played with a tame seal that belonged to the store. This seal made a daily visit to all of the boats. Everyone kept something on their boat for it to play with, and I had a piece of trolling pole that I would chuck off when I saw the seal coming. It would grab the pole with its flippers and swim round and round. It used to come home every evening to the store and crawl up and lie down behind the stove. Amazing. So just love, full of stories like that, of the people, the wildlife, their pets, their gardens. Wonderful. The third book, and actually the first one that jumped out at me from the library bookshelves and made me think of the other two and the similarities, is Tony Taylor's Fishing the River of Time. Taylor is a retired geologist and paleontologist who lived in the Cowichan Lake area in a remote cabin in the late 1960s, and then comes back in 2008 to teach his grandson how to fish. So it's really interesting. He talks about the differences in the environment between the 60s and now. Sometimes it's not so pleasant, but it reminds me of Thoreau's Walden. It's a real meditation about the joys of living simply, in harmony with nature, living off the land. He's a real philosopher, and yet the story is full of snippets of information about the early explorers around Vancouver Island, the First Nations ways of life here, the origins of local place names, which often come from the early Chinook language, the variety of salmon and trout that are found in the Cowichan River. It's all super interesting. And he even says in the book that in the 60s, Field and Stream magazine named the Cowichan River one of the top six fishing rivers in the world. So it was a really internationally famous area. I highly recommend all three of these books, especially if you love memoirs, adventure stories, and just learning about this amazing area that we live in. And especially the tales about the interesting people who love the remoteness and the richness of this beautiful area. All right, enjoy.